Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to export and import events to ICS files in Angular Scheduler component. You will also learn how to print events. First, I open my existing Angular application, where I've added the basic code to render the Angular Scheduler. To learn more about integrating the scheduler component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. I run this application using the command ng-serve. See, the scheduler component is rendered with the provided appointments. To enable ICS exporting, I open the app module TS file, import the iCalendar export service from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Schedule package, and register it in the providers array of the ng module. Then, I need to add the toolbar item to export the calendar. To do that, I include the ActionBegin event and assign the callback method on ActionBegin. I open the app component TS file and define the method on ActionBegin. It receives an argument of type toolbar action arguments imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Schedule package. Inside this method, I add a condition to check whether the request type is toolbar item rendering. I also declare the variable export item of type item model. I import the item model from the Syncfusion EJ2 navigations package. Then, I set the text as export calendar and push the export item to the item's property of the toolbar action arguments. See, the export calendar toolbar option is added. When this item is clicked, events should be exported to an ICS file. So, I bind the click event to the item and assign the callback method on export click. I define this method here. Before proceeding further, I need to create a reference for the scheduler to access its built-in methods. So, I add the reference variable to the scheduler component. In the app component TS file, I import the viewchild directive from the Angular core package. Using this directive, I'll declare a scheduler object instance variable. Inside the onExportClick method, I call the exportToICalendar method using the scheduler object. When I click this export calendar item, events will be exported to the ICS file. By default, ICS files are saved with the name calendar. I can also export the events with a custom name. I'll pass the custom name scheduler events as a string in the export to iCalendar method. Check now, the exported document's name is scheduler events. Next, I'll show you how to import this ICS file to the scheduler component. In the app module TS file, import the iCalendarImport service from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Schedule package and inject it into the providers array of the ng module. To demonstrate the import feature, I use the Syncfusion Uploader component. To install the component, I run the command ng add Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Inputs package. See, the uploader module is automatically imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Inputs package and injected into the imports array of the ng module. Then, I add the EJS uploader component with a few basic options. To learn more about integrating the uploader component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started documentation linked in the description below. Now, I am going to process the ICS file selected in the uploader component. So, I add the selected event and assign the callback method on file select. I open the app component TS file and define the method on file select. This method receives an argument of type selected event arguments, imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Inputs package. I declare a variable file and get the event target and access the file as a blob. Using the scheduler object, call the method importICalendar and pass this file. I'll also pass the empty array to the datasource property of event settings to import the ICS file. Check now, the scheduler is rendered without any events. If I choose the ICS file, it will be imported. Events created from Outlook can also be imported. Open Outlook, click this calendar icon, and then click any of the events. It will prompt just this one or the entire series. I'll choose the entire series. Save this file in iCalendar format. When I import this format into the scheduler, you can see the entire series. Finally, I will show you how to print scheduler events. Import the print service from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Schedule package and register it in the providers array of the NG module. Inside the onActionBegin method, I declare another variable, printItem, and assign the text as print and prefix icon to eIconEprint. Next, change the clickEventCallback method name to onPrintClick. I define this method here. Inside this method, I call the print method using the scheduler object and pass the options height and width. And push the print item to the items property of the toolbar action arguments. At last, assign the data source to the event settings. Checking now, the print toolbar option is added. When I click this item, a print preview window opens where you can see the events. In this video, I showed you how to export and import calendar events to ICS files in the Angular Scheduler component and print events. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our Angular products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.